He said, you're not your own, you've been bought with a price. You know what that means in 1 Corinthians 6:19? He said, the reason I tell you you're not your own is you were bought with that price. Yeah. Yeah. I gave my body, 1 Peter 2:24, on the truth. I expect nothing less back. I want your body.
Yes.
Somebody shout, he wants my body. The Holy Ghost just prophetically, because it is equivalent to prophecy, tongues interpreted. Come on, somebody. And that's another thing. Thank God. I go to so many Pentecostal churches, they don't even know what that is no more. Listen. 1 Corinthians 6:13, the Lord's for the body, and the body is for the Lord. Somebody say, my body's not my own.
My body's not my own.
That's why we defend life unborn. Because though that life may be in your body, ma'am, if you belong to Christ, your body's not yours, and the body of that life in you is not yours either. Anything done with that child otherwise is murder.
Yes.
Ain't it so? A woman pregnant can get hit on by a drunk driver in our nation. And both her and the child be killed. And that man or woman, whoever, will stand trial for first degree murder.
Yes. Yeah.
For two counts.
For
both the mother and child. But if that same lady had been on her way to the abortion clinic and would allow them to take scissors, amen, after having pulled the baby's body out of her womb, but legally, as long as they left the head in, and then shove a syringe, come on somebody, and vacuum that baby's brains out, now so-called it's legal, all in the name of women's health and choice. You can call it what you want to, Mr. Obama, but it's murder! And the blood, hallelujah, from them babies cries out from the ground like the blood of Abel did in Genesis 4:10. And I want you to know there's a God that sees all the blood that's been spilled in this nation for the last almost now 43 years. 55 million plus! One of the most unsafe places to live in America is the womb. We got politicians that say, well, we got to go after ISIS. We got to go after the terrorists. We got to get them. Well, in God's eyes, they're worse terrorists than even the ones they pursue. One terrorist takes a sword, chops the brains and head off of its victim. But the other one, with its pen, amen, glory to God, in Congress, signs pieces of papers, amen, and judges who now say, I'm God, and God's no longer in rule and throne. I am. I'm above God. Come on, somebody. And I say what goes. Praise God. Amen. And this terrorist, glory to God, that's worse, amen, takes a syringe or a vacuum. Sucks out its victim's brains. All in the name of freedom. We've sown mass murder in private places for 43 years. No wonder we're reaping it publicly.
Yes, that's right.
All the politicians who are nothing but Baal worshipers modernly. Because you know what Baal worship looked like in the Old Testament? Baal worship was the figure, amen, of a God seated on the throne who from his waist down was a man, but from his waist up was a bull.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Hello? And in the belly of that God, they would throw their newborn infants. And while those infants' flesh, amen, burning, filled the air with a stench and a stink, they would have sexual orgies on Baal's altar, amen, glory to God, amen, with a pornographic, amen, male sex organ resurrected and erected. Come on, somebody. Men with men, women with women, women with men, it didn't matter. Men with women, it didn't matter. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? It's been flowered up in its terms and its tenets in America. But Baal worship in America ain't nothing but the abortion agenda. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. where we throw our own, amen, glory to God, to false gods, where we slay them by the masses, amen, where we think we can have sex freely, amen, have it like ever we want it, with whomever we want it, and it's okay, and redefine what marriage is. But I want you to know in Genesis 1, 28, God blessed them. He didn't bless hims, and he didn't bless hers. He blessed them, and them was a him and a her. And only him. I find in scripture that was referred to as a her is in Exodus 17. There was a man called Moses. Joshua was fighting down in the valley. And as long as Moses kept his arms up, Joshua got victory and the sun stood still. There's salt kind of right there. But there was one man named Aaron, which was Moses' brother, and there happened to be another man named Hur.
Yes. Come on.
H-U-R. That's the only him I ever found her. Somebody say, dude may look like a lady, but dude ain't no lady. If you're attracted to the same sex, you got a devil. Come to the altar and repent and we'll cast it out in the name of Jesus. Get out of here, the Holy Ghost. And if you can't stop sleeping with everybody else, you got a devil too. Repent and let somebody in the Holy Ghost cast.